Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics, and today we will see the difference between the ideal and the practical current source. So if you see any ideal current source, it delivers a constant current to the load no matter what amount of voltage that appears across this current source. So if we see current versus voltage plot, it looks like this. So no matter what amount of voltage that appears across this current source, it delivers a constant current to the given load. Now, the voltage that appears across this current source depends upon the load. Let's assume that the load here is resistive load. So if we connect a load resistance RL to the ideal current source IS, then the voltage that appears across this current source can be given as V is equal to IS into RL. So as the value of this resistance RL increases, the amount of voltage that appears across this current source will increase. So in case of ideal current source, there is no limit on the amount of voltage that appears across this source. Or in other way, we can say that the ideal current source can deliver any amount of voltage to the load. But if you see any practical current source, there is a limitation on the amount of voltage that can appear across the current source. Or in another way, there is a limitation on the amount of voltage that can be supplied to the load. Apart from that, the practical current source have a shunt resistance in parallel with the current source. So the current I that actually delivered to the load can be given as I is equal to IS minus V upon shunt resistance, where IS is the supply current, RS is the shunt resistance, V is the voltage that appears across the load, and I is the current that is flowing through the load resistance. So as the value of the voltage that appears across this current source increases, the actual current that is flowing through the load will reduce. So if we see the current versus voltage plot, as the voltage across this current source increases, the actual current that flows through this load will reduce, because there will be the leakage current through this shunt resistance. So to reduce this leakage current, the value of this shunt resistance should be as high as possible. In practical current sources, the value of the shunt resistance is in the range of mega ohms. So now let's see through an example that how the value of the shunt resistance affect the output current. So here we have a two current sources with the same value of current but with a different value of the shunt resistance. These two current sources are connected with the same load of 1 kilo ohm. So the current that is flowing through this 1 kilo ohm load can be given using the current divider rule as 10 milliampere into 1 meg divided by 1 meg plus 1 kilo ohm. So the current IL that is flowing through the load resistance will be the 9.990 milliampere. While in the second case, if you see the current IL that is flowing through this 1 kilo ohm resistor will be the 9.999 milliampere. So as you can see here, as the value of the shunt resistance increases, the leakage current through this shunt resistance reduces, and the amount of current that is flowing through the load resistor will increase. So we can say that the value of the shunt resistance should be as high as possible. So now let's summarize the difference between the ideal and the practical current source. So in case of ideal current source, there is no shunt resistance, or we can say that the shunt resistance in the ideal current source is infinite. So all the current will flow through the load resistor. While in case of a practical current source, it do have some shunt resistance. So all the current will not flow through the load resistor. There will be some leakage current through this shunt resistance. In case of an ideal current source, it supplies a constant current to the load no matter of the voltage that appears across this current source. Now in case of a practical current source, the current that is supplied to the load depend upon the voltage that appears across this current source. So as the voltage across this current source increases, the amount of current that flows through the load will reduce. Or in another way, we can say that as the load resistance increases, the amount of current that flows through this load will reduce. Now the ideal current source can supply any amount of voltage to the given load. While in case of practical current source, the amount of voltage that can be supplied to the load is limited. So I hope you understood the difference between the ideal and the practical current source. If you have any question or suggestion, please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.